Supplementary questions, Honourable Van der Merwe.
Thank you very much, Speaker, and to you, Deputy President. I think you would agree with me that all the government programs that you've just outlined has been severely undermined by your government's decision to grant diplomatic immunity to Dr. Grace Mugabe, yeah, who has been alleged to have severely beaten up and injured a South African woman. Yes. And I would like to know from you, Honourable Deputy President, what type of government would stand on the side of an alleged abuser while denying justice to Ms. Engels? And I think as leader of government business, you must provide us some answers today and clarity on this decision. And maybe you can also indicate whether you support the decision to grant diplomatic immunity to Dr. Grace Mugabe and what you think this decision will actually do for our fight against gender-based violence in South Africa. Honourable Deputy.
Honourable Deputy President.
Thank you very much. As I understand, the decision was taken in terms of the internationally recognized immunity regulations, which regulations and conventions are understood and also well recognized at the UN level. So that was the instrument that was utilized for this purpose. Now, clearly, it has its own sub-regulations in terms of its own efficacy. Now, it's the first time that we have utilized this type of convention, and a lot can be said on pro and against it. And in the end, there needs to be the clarity that there is.
Honourable members.
The clarity that there is on this matter is not full and complete, in the sense that, yes, in certain environments it is applied, in others it is not applied. So it happens to have been applied here in South Africa, and our government and international department granted this immunity, which enabled Mrs. Mugabe then to depart in the way that she departed. Thank you very much.